Ever since the Oklahoma City bombing, a lot of attention is focused on Timothy McVeigh and his connection to a group of fun-loving guys in my home state known as the Michigan Militia. McVeigh and his partner, Terry Nichols, were reported to have ties to the militia, self-described patriots who are demanding that the federal government return power to the local citizens, or else. They carry lots of guns, wear lots of cool camouflage, and spend their weekends communing with nature. Many of them lost their jobs in the last recession, and like McVeigh, the son of a GM auto worker, they're more than a little pissed off.
The federal government itself is the child of the armed citizen. You, senators, are part of the child that we, the people, gave life to. The federal government needs a good spanking to make it behave.
That's Norm Olsen, commander of the Michigan Militia's Northern Unit. He's a preacher and a retired Air Force officer. I know the past decade has been tough in Michigan, but with over 12,000 people having joined this armed militia, I saw no choice but to go back home and convince them to put down their guns. This was not the welcome back to Michigan greeting I was expecting. I told Norm that I wanted him and his militia to disband and join Mike's militia. After some coaxing, Norm agreed to give it a try. So we were off to my favorite place, the kitchen.
Why do you think Oklahoma City happened?
I think perhaps that there is a conspiracy afoot.
You think the government was involved in blowing up the
building? Oh, yes.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Well,
she's
supposed to have gone off at 6 a.m. before the building was occupied. Then it would have been a very powerful political statement.
Here's my question.
Tim McVeigh.
As soon as he was arrested, he said, I have had a chip implanted in my buttocks when I was in the service.
He claimed that he was mind controlled. The stuff out of James Bond is real.
Norm sure had a lot of theories.
Foreign troops are training on U.S. soil.
True.
Vince Foster was murdered.
True.
The CIA controls the nightly news as well as popular sitcoms such as The Nanny and Friends.
Only Peter Jennings and the staff of ABC and Time Warner.
Pacifism will get you marched down into a pit and machine gunned. I believe the hour is far more desperate, and so we're taking up the guns.
The anti-terrorism legislation, I think, is going too fast, too far. And if that stuff passes, Mike, what's going to happen is there's going to be some cowboy hero, Rambo, ATF, or FBI, or state policeman who's going to try to push it. He's going to feel like he's going to go out there and save the world from the militia, and he's going to open fire, and we're going to open fire it back.
You will fire back?
Absolutely.
Are you ready to die right now?
Mm-hmm.
The cake went down easy. At Norm's gun shop next door, he sells all kinds of ammunition.
I sell Bibles right along with the...
The Bible is a...
That's the spiritual warfare.
This is the gun, this
carnal
is
warfare.
The Bible.
One more lethal than the other.
Liberty 25.
What was that? A police scanner.
Oh, yeah? Just for...
Gives me a little heads up.
Have you ever practiced the drill, though, to actually... how to get out of here quickly?
No, my... I don't... to be honest with you, Mike, I don't have a drill. Because this is my home, this is where my family is.
You're
this is where
it.
No, this is where I stand, this is where I fight, this is where I'll die if necessary.
Norm was clear about where he stood, and I realized it wasn't going to be easy getting him to go the route of Gandhi.
Is there any way I could get you to come down my road? You'd have to take off the camouflage, you'd have to, you know, give up the guns, you know, but we'd find sort of a non-gun way of turning this country around.
But what about Waco? How are we ever...
What about coming with me? That's what I'm saying.
Okay, sure. I'll you know, walk your way for a while. Let's see where it goes.
Norm and his boys agreed to leave the guns behind and join me at my training camp. Although they were now disarmed, they wouldn't take off their camouflage. But that's okay. There's no dress code in Mike's militia.
In Mike's militia, this is how you'd spend the weekend.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Hey, all right, Ray.
If I was going to be their leader, I needed to show them that I cared.
What have you lost?
Everything.
I lost a job, a business,
our freedoms.
The news media.
News media.
Absolutely destroyed me.
You get to the point where you got nothing left, and they can't take anything away from you now.
This country's heading to civil war, because this is the final step.
What do you think about my idea of Maybe if it would be better if we have more than two political parties.
How about if we frighten the guys that are in there and the gals that are in there?
Which political party is going to say, we put the uniforms on and pick the guns up so that they would watch us, so they would see us, and they would have to hear us and listen to us. But we're down to two options and two options only. Either you listen to us or you destroy us.
I tried to get them to sing a few songs of peace, and although none of us could carry a tune, their hearts started to melt.
I had a hammer.
Norm and the boys shared visions of another Waco.
If there's another Ruby Ridge, it's going to be a different story.
You're not just talking that talk.
No, we'll be there. Right. Take a picture of this in your mind's eye. Here we had 5,000 feet, a chopper taking photographs of a mass of green militiamen, 10,000 strong, with the press in tow, marching across the field, going toward the Mount Carmel.
The guys had gone too long without guns and were beginning to get testy. So I had an idea.
How many have you got?
One for one.
Try this one.
Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya. Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya. Kumbaya, lord. Kumbaya.
It'd be a lot better if you guys just, you know, use the play guns.
Put the guns away and we'll all give daisies to each other. Huh?
Yeah.
No. Norm, you were almost there.
Yeah.
Do it like the ATF does it.
Hey, all right.
Every time I thought I was making progress, Norm came back slugging.
We're the parents. We gave birth to that government.
And when the child is bad?
You spank it. You discipline it. You give it a good whacking.
But he had his gentle side, too.
The cathedral where I could bow and pray. Where God was never far away. My thoughts go back to Teddy and Ann and the calico cat.
As the day drew to an end, I felt the time was right to ask the Michigan Militia to officially join Mike's Militia.
Now my oath.
Repeat after me.
I Norman Olsen.
Mike Whitten.
Ray Southwell.
Do solemnly swear
that I will live my life
by the following principle.
Blessed are the peacemakers.
For they shall inherit the earth.
Congratulations. I like that.
All right.
Boy,
live by it now.